Today we'll look at the software update workflow engine in System Center Configuration Manager, which now natively supports Office 365 clients. We'll show you how to enable it, how it works, and your options. With System Center Configuration Manager, Office 365 clients, including Office 365 ProPlus, Visio Pro, and Project Pro, can now receive updates using the new servicing capabilities. Now you can leverage Configuration Manager's built-in workflow engine to natively distribute software updates. It's pretty straightforward to enable it, so let me show you how. First, we're going to go into the configuration.xml file, and I'm going to add this new Office Management COM and set it to true. This will now enable Office clients to be able to be managed by Configuration Manager. For those of you who are enabling this feature for existing Office 365 clients, you're going to want to go ahead and leverage the group policy object and enable it by clicking on the Office 365 Client Management and selecting the Enable button. Now that your Office clients are aware of Configuration Manager, let's walk through what the software update process looks like. Each time a new build is uploaded to the Office 365 Cloud, a new package is also published to the Microsoft Update Center. System Center Configuration Manager will download that package and identify which PCs are applicable to it. Once it has completed that, it will go ahead and request for those software updates directly from the Office 365 Cloud. Now note, this is a key difference on how the Microsoft Update Service works, where it actually provides a software package as part of the initial package. Once the update request has been received, it will go ahead and download all the necessary files to update Office to the site server, and then distribute it to all the distribution points across your network. So now let's go to the Configuration Management console and see what this looks like. Now before Configuration Manager can download the actual updates, we're going to need to make sure that your system is configured to be able to detect and download the actual software. And to do so, we're going to have to go into the site server and specifically configure the software update points to detect the classification and products of the new Office 365 client updates. And what we'll have to do under classification is select the updates, and then under products, we're going to want to make sure that the Office 365 client, which is a brand new category, is checked and available for the downloads. Once you have done that, we're going to go back into the software library and go under all software updates to actually search for the actual software packages. I'm going to type in Office 365 client. And you'll see we have a number of updates available here. We have multiple options that the workflow enables us to do. One, I can right-click and select to just download and stage my packages across my individual distribution points, or I can download and directly deploy to a targeted machine. Let me show you what it looks like to download. Now, when I'm creating a package, I'm going to want to create a brand new deployment package. I'm going to type in the title of this, called Office 365 Client. And I'm going to select a location to where the package should download on my site server. I'm going to select a predefined location and create a new folder. I'm going to call this Finance Team and make sure I select the folder and then click on Next. Here I'm going to select the distribution points that I want to be able to distribute the actual packages to. I'm going to select Next, and then continue to select the defaults that are available to me here in the workflow. You can see at one point I'm going to have the different languages that I would like to download. Here we have a couple of things like Estonia, Finnish, French. I'm going to go ahead and select Next, and then complete that actual workflow process. What you're seeing here is the ability for System Center Configuration Manager to send that request directly to the Office 365 Cloud, and then download those bits directly onto that site server. And as you saw, the rules are going to go ahead and distribute those files directly to the individual distribution points. Once we've downloaded all of the files, let's see what we can actually do with the deployment packages. We can actually start deploying the packages out to individual targeted users, or I can create an automatic rule like I have here for my finance team. As you can see here, what we're trying to do is target our finance team for our first release for deferred bits. By doing so, I'm going to set up a search criteria that's going to look for the first release for deferred channels, automatically download these bits, and distribute those out to those individual targeted machines. Now, one more thing. For those of you who have not moved to the latest version of Configuration Manager, we've also made available scripts for Configuration Manager 2007 and 2012 on GitHub to find the closest distribution points for software updates to override the update path settings dynamically. These are available at the link below. What I've shown you today is available in the current channel and first release for deferred channel. Broad availability for deferred channel will roll out in June later this year. Keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for more demo benches and updates. Thanks for watching.